Hello, family. My name is Wandile Shabangu, and I'm standing with Chloe Lowe, my spiritual twin sister, and we're going to be sharing for communion. You know, it's really an honor. I just want to thank Andrew Patrick, Kate and Talani for allowing us to share. It is really a pleasure to be a part of the special service that we are having today. Can we turn our Bibles to 2 Peter chapter 1, verses 3 to 4? It reads as follows. His divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life through our knowledge of him who called us by his own glory and goodness. Through these, he has given us his very great and precious promise so that through them you may participate in the divine nature, having escaped the corruption in the world caused by evil desires. Wow, this is a very powerful scripture, which really allows me to also reflect from where I came from myself and the corruption that I came from myself. You know, the world has given me morals that I thought were correct, you know, worldly correct, I guess. You know, a person who doesn't go out so much, a person doesn't go to clubs, a person doesn't drink, a person who's not abusive, a person who's loving and caring and just there for their family. You know, I thought that was just the standard of who a good person should be, but also not acknowledging that we have been corrupted by the world's vision of what is good to have in our lives, like money, cars, women. You know, these are things that I thought that I should have, or I should work towards having, because that is what would give me a happy life. You know, we are looking for a happy life, but all those things took us away from God and what we should be searching for. And once I started studying the Bible, I started seeing that all these morals that I thought I had and all these things that I thought were good about me are very far from what God really calls us to and who we should be in God's eyes. And that for me made me feel like a liar to my own self, you know? It made me feel like I was broken and incorrect about so much. It gave me a lot to think about, but also it built me by seeing that I need to challenge myself to not just live as a person of this world, but to live purely through the Spirit of God and having him to lead me. And this is just a really powerful scripture to also just really reflect of that and who we are today. And if we've really been corrupted by this world, I'll be allowing my sister Chloe Lowe to also share.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, family. Thank you so much to Andrew and Patrick, as well as Kate and Talani, for allowing me to share my heart for communion this morning. I really appreciate the scripture that Wandile shared because it helped me connect to where I was a few years ago. And it helped me to connect to what the cross means to me, which is being saved from the depravity of my life. When I was 4 to 5 years old, I was sexually abused by several different people for several years. The feelings of abuse left me with a lot of ambivalence, and my understanding of love, my understanding of safety and security became very distorted. I remember feeling very sad, heartbroken, confused, neglected, isolated, and powerless. And my mind became very depraved, and my heart was permanently wounded. And the little girl that I was not the little girl I was before. I remember just feeling a deep sense of yearning and desire for love, and I didn't know where to find it. A few years after being abused, I turned to pornography as well as impurity as a way to find love, to find safety, to find comfort, to find peace. And it became a decade-long addiction that I had. But like any other idol that you place before God, it just left me feeling much more empty, much more shame, embarrassment, and I just felt really disgusted by who I was. I dug myself into a very deep hole and I didn't see a way out. And when I got into high school, I started smoking weed so that I could escape the depraved reality that I was living. And I would smoke weed every day that I went to school as a means to escape from my life and just how I hated it. At the same time, I was going to church. I was a quote unquote Christian and I was serving in church, but the truth is no one even in that church knew God's word, knew him enough to see through my hypocrisy, to see through my lies and my deceit and the life that I was really living. No one really knew who I was. And I just became so much more deprived as the years continued to pass by. It got to a point where I hated myself so much so that I was willing to sell myself to men. I told myself, you know what, I'm not worthy, I'm not valued, and no one could ever love me. And then earlier this year, I started studying the Bible and God showed me the truth. God showed me a way out through his love. He showed me that there is something different than the life that I've been exposed to. And every day I have the opportunity to overcome my temptations through his word. Ladies, are you struggling with sin? Are you struggling with sin that is corrupting your life and taking you away from your relationship with God? If you're a guest joining us today, I want to encourage you, please study the Bible with us. There is a way out. There is a way for you to find healing. There is a way for you to know the truth and a way for you to leave this corruptible world that we live in. Jesus did it for me, and I know that he can do it for you. Thank you.
Thank you so much for sharing that. Chloe, family, this just brings us to see that really what God has done for us through the cross and his own son, Jesus Christ, is just really amazing. This is our second chance to not only walk away from our sins, but to live a completely new life and devote our lives to God and really change who we are. Are the standards that we have set for ourselves the standards of God? Do we understand or love not just God, but do we love ourselves enough to really improve who we are and make a change in not only our lives, but the lives of those who are around us and the influences that destroy young minds like ours? You know, family, these are the type of questions I started asking myself before I went ahead and really got into my Bible studies and decided to make this change and become baptized in the name of Jesus. It's just really amazing that we can make this change and give ourselves a second chance to be with God and ultimately just grow within our faith and really follow through with who God wants us to be through studying the Bible. Let us pray. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, I just want to thank you so much for your word today, for encouraging us to just see the evil that is in this world and the evil within our hearts, our minds, our past, and our thoughts of the future, Lord. And just to be able to change those things right now as we hold the Bible and study and give ourselves to you, Lord. Give us the heart to not only have strength to fight away all this sin, but to also go ahead and fight for our own souls and break the chains that the devil has placed on us to hold us away from you, Lord. Give us the strength as well to just really pursue our dreams through you, Lord, to not only grow ourselves, but to grow your kingdom and show those who are too deep into their sin who exactly you are, and that their perception of what the devil has taught them about you, Lord, is nothing that they have seen and is not true, but let the Bible guide them to you, Lord, and strengthen their faith in you, Lord. And I pray for this in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.